Good morning, students. Welcome to online teaching session of Academic World School, Demetra. In the last class, I taught the types of polymerization based on the formation of byproduct. Example, addition polymerization. In that, we get only one main product, that is addition polymer. There is no byproduct, remember. And second type of polymerization was condensation polymerization. In condensation polymerization, besides the main product, that is polymer, we get the byproduct. Simple molecule like water, hydrochloric acid, ammonia, gaseous molecule. So in addition polymerization, we will get only one product. In condensation polymerization, besides main product, we will get simple products like water, HCl and NH3. Up to this we discuss it. And under addition polymerization, we discuss free radical mechanism. By that mechanism, how is addition polymer formed? After that we discuss it, and today we are going to discuss about the important addition polymers. Same unit, polymers, and in that today we are going to discuss two topics. Topic one is some important addition polymers. Remember again, characteristic property or formation of these addition polymers is whatever number of examples we are going to see. In them, there will be only one product. There is no other simple product in the case of addition polymerization. That is what you need to remember. In topic 1, we have three addition polymers. Now let us see chemistry of those three addition polymers. First addition polymer is polyethylene. This is the first important addition polymer. And second important addition polymer is polytetrafluoroethene. The market name of this polymer is Teflon. That is second type. And third type of addition polymer is polyacrylonitrile. It is nothing but PAN. In short, it is known as, in the market, it is popular with the name PAN. That is polyacrylonitrile. So first addition polymer is polyethylene. Second, polytetrafluoroethene or Teflon, and third one is polyacrylonitrile or PAN. Now let us see the first one, that is polyethylene. Here polyethylene, polytetrafluoroethene, and then PAN. These three can be considered as subtopics. Right. First let us see polyethylene. This is nothing but one of the important addition polymers. And this polyethylene is divided into two types based on the conditions it is yielded, based on the weight of that polyethylene so formed. And they are, number one, low density polyethylene. It is also known as LDP. So first one is low density polyethylene. It can be abbreviated by LDP. Low density polyethylene. Second one is high density polyethylene. That we will see little later. First, let us see low density polyethylene. How is this low density polythene formed? The monomer of LDP is again ethene or ethylene micromolecules. So these are micromolecules, or we can call them as monomers. And these monomers are nothing but ethene. Ethene micromolecules are ethene monomers. And these ethene monomers, they undergo polymerization, means repeated chemical combination. That is the meaning of polymerization. As a result, we will get polyethylene, and this is polyethylene. Already this was taught. And this polyethylene is nothing but polymer. So its name is polyethylene. And whenever we write polyethylene towards right hand side, after the closing round bracket, we write small n. Before this composition, if we write small n, that will become monomer. Now, during polymerization, pressure should be 1000 to 2000 atm. Temperature should be 350 to 370 Kelvin. And the catalyst that is required in this reaction is benzoyl peroxide. This is benzoyl peroxide. Right, that is C6H5CO2. That is composition of benzoyl peroxide. So these things you need to remember. Pressure should be 1000 to 2000 atmospheres. ATM is abbreviation of atmosphere, that is nothing but unit of pressure. Temperature should be 350 to 370 Kelvin. Catalyst should be benzoyl peroxide. That is how low density polyethylene is prepared. Next, properties. The name low density itself indicates that in the case of LDP, during its formation, micromolecules or monomers are not closely packed. As a result, the weight of LDP comes down. Therefore, it becomes light, or its density becomes low. This is the reason why LDP is used in making of number one, toys, number two, squeeze bottles. Means once we consume water, immediately that bottle will squeeze and will throw it. Number three, it is used in making of flexible pipes. Once again, LDP, that is low density polyethylene, is used in making of number one, carry bags, polythene carry bags. Number two, it is used in making of toys. Number three, it is used in making of flexible pipes. And last one is, it is used in making of squeeze bottles. That's about chemistry of low density polyethylene. Right, now let us see chemistry of high density polyethylene. How is it prepared? That is second type of polyethylene. It is high density polyethylene. It can be abbreviated by HDP, high density polythene. The name itself is informative. During formation of this HDP, all the monomers are again same, ethene only. Polymer composition is also same, that is polythene. Right? So if you want, you can write instead of these general names, in this way also you can write ethene or ethylene monomers. In this way also you can write are ethene micromolecules, and here this is polymer. So you can write polythene polymer or polythene macromolecule. Now let us see the conditions of formation of this HDP. In this case, we are going to use the catalyst, that is Ziegler Natta catalyst. Next, here temperature should be 333 to 343 Kelvin. Next, pressure should be 6 to 7 atm. Right? This is what you need to remember. 6 to 7 atm means it can be 6.2 atmospheres or 6.3, 6.8 or 7 atmosphere. That is the meaning. Okay? These are the conditions. And here we are using the catalyst, that is named catalyst, Ziegler Natta catalyst. This is important from your examination point of view. You may be asked, what does Ziegler Natta catalyst consists of? Now let us see its composition. Ziegler Natta catalyst consists of triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride. Triethyl aluminium and then titanium tetrachloride. So mixture of these two reagents are mixed. As a result, we get single catalyst. That is called Ziegler Natta catalyst. First time, the chemist Ziegler and the other chemist Natta, together they developed this catalyst in order to make HDP, high density polythene. That's why they were awarded Nobel Prize. That is the reason why this catalyst is known after the name of those chemists as Ziegler Natta catalyst. This is important. This is what you need to remember. And these conditions. In the case of LDP, pressure was 1000 to 2000 atmospheres. Their temperature was 350 to 370 Kelvin. And here in the case of HDP, catalyst is different. There we used benzoyl peroxide. And here it is Ziegler Natta catalyst. Catalyst is different. Temperature is also different, 333 to 343 Kelvin. And in this case, pressure is very low when compared to the pressure applied during preparation of LDP. So here the pressure is 6 to 7 atm. Right, because of the effect of this Ziegler Natta catalyst, what happens is, all the micromolecules of ethene, or ethene monomers, they get closely packed. When they get closely packed, automatically the weight of that polythene increases, or its density increases. That is why it is said to be high high density polythene. That's about preparation. Next, as far as properties are concerned, number one, high density polythene is poor conductor of electricity like that of LDP. This is similarity. So HDP and LDP both have similarity, that is both are poor conductors of electricity. Number two, since density of this polythene is more when compared to LDP, therefore mass of this HDP is more than LDP. Number two, HDP, high density polymer, is tougher than LDP. Number two, number three, high density polythene is harder than low density polythene. Right? Then in LDP, you came across the term flexibility. LDP is used in flexible pipes because of flexibility of LDP. Whereas high density polymer, that is high density polythene, is harder. It is not as flexible as LDP. Therefore, it is used in making of buckets, plastic bucket, plastic jug, right? HDP is also used in making of pipes. But these pipes are not flexible pipes as in the case of LDP we observe. Right? That's about properties and uses of high density polythene. So here you need to remember the name of the catalyst and its composition and the conditions. Conditions means temperature and pressure. That's about second addition polymer. Now we will see third addition polymer and its chemistry. Third addition polymer is polytetrafluoroethene. It is popular in the market with the name Teflon. You might have heard Teflon coating. That coating is done with the help of polytetrafluoroethene. Now let us see its chemistry. This is the other important addition polymer. The monomers involved during making up this polytetrafluoroethene is CF2 double bond CF2. Here fluorine atoms you can show on any side, left hand side or right hand side. This should be n number of times. So its name is tetrafluoroethene. Monomers are micromolecules. And these tetrafluoroethene monomers, when they undergo polymerization, means repeated chemical combination, it leads to the formation of only one product. That's why it is said to be addition polymer. And that product is CF2 single bond CF2. See here, we have one pi bond in tetrafluoroethene. Whenever that pi bond is removed, we have to show two single bonds and both the sides are CF2. And we can put here round brackets or square brackets. And then, yarn which we have shown in front of tetrafluoroethene monomers should be shown towards right hand side as a substrate. Then it will become polymer. Now its name is polytetrafluoroethene. Polytetrafluoroethene, or it can also be abbreviated by PTFE, and it is popular with the name Teflon in the market. And here we need to remember two things. One is the catalyst used. That catalyst is ammonium persulfate, NFO twice, H2O8, and pressure should be high pressure. Once again, PTFE is known in the market with the popular name, that is Teflon. And this PTFE is prepared or made with tetrafluoroethene monomers. And in this case, we are using the catalyst, that is ammonium persulfate. So this is called ammonium persulfate. This is the catalyst. Right, this catalyst is used. So that's about preparation. Now come to properties. The main property of Teflon is it is non-sticky in nature. That is the important characteristic property of polytetrafluoroethene or Teflon. Since it is non-sticky in nature, here nature of Teflon itself is the important property. Number two, second property is this Teflon undergoes decomposition when it is heated to 300 degrees centigrade. This is what you need to remember. Now let us see uses. Based on the property of PTFE or Teflon, it is used as a coating substance or a coating material over utensils, iron box. In that also, this Teflon coating is there. So that when that iron box is heated to high temperature, cloth cannot stick to it. Right? And utensils. In the case of utensils also, the upper surface is coated by Teflon. You can see Teflon coating. So whenever the edible thing is made, example roti, temperature should not cross 300 degrees centigrade. If that pan is heated continuously, means if temperature reaches 300 or it goes beyond 300, this Teflon coating lying over utensil undergoes decomposition. So below that coating metal is there, that gets exposed. Next time when roti is made, when temperature becomes more, that roti sticks to it. Number two, when the cloth is ironed, when it is being ironed, when that Teflon coating gets decomposed because of very high temperature, means when we heat it beyond 300 degrees centigrade, the Teflon coating decomposes and that iron box or that cloth gets sticked to it, or that cloth can be burnt. So that's about chemistry of polytetrafluoroethene. So its popular name in the market is Teflon, which is non-sticky material, a non-sticky polymer, a non-sticky reagent. Therefore, it is used as a coating over utensils. That's about chemistry of Teflon. Next, let us see the third important addition polymer. That is polyacrylonitrile, PAN. It can be abbreviated by PAN. It is popular with this name. That is PAN. Polyacrylonitrile. Now let us see its chemistry. So chemistry of each addition polymer means its preparation, its property, and then its use. So third addition polymer, how is it prepared? Poly refers to polymer. If you remove this poly, right, in the name, we will have acrylonitrile. That acrylonitrile itself is monomer or micromolecule. And its composition is CH2 double bond CHCl. This should be N times. So its name is acrylonitrile. Or in the previous class, vinyl chloride was taken as an example for addition polymer. So there in vinyl chloride, it was written like this. CH2 double bond CHCl. When this Cl is removed, we will get vinyl group. This is called vinyl group. So same group is there in acrylonitrile, right? CH2CH. So that is vinyl. Thereafter we have CN functional group, that is cyanide. Therefore, acrylonitrile is also known as vinyl cyanide. So, this group is called vinyl group. So, that's how you need to remember. So, acrylonitrile or vinyl cyanide monomers are micromolecules. When they undergo polymerization, that is repeated chemical combination, then we will get PAN. And that PAN, that is polyacrylonitrile or polyvinyl cyanide polymer, can be shown like this. So this is called polyacrylonitrile. This CN you can show above this carbon atom as you like. Okay, this is composition of polyacrylonitrile. And here catalyst is used in this reaction, and that catalyst is peroxide. That means the catalyst can be acetyl peroxide or it can be benzoyl peroxide, right? And suitable temperature and pressure they are required. So here monomers are acrylonitrile or vinyl cyanide. These are the micromolecules or monomers. When they undergo polymerization in presence of benzoyl peroxide, we get the polymer, that is polyacrylonitrile or polyvinyl cyanide. Here cyanide is functional group. Now let us see the properties. This PAN or polyacrylonitrile cannot be attacked by fungi. It cannot be attacked by any insects. Therefore, this is the main property. It cannot be attacked by fungi or any insects. Therefore, this PAN can be used as a substitute for woolen materials. Woolen materials, right? So PAN is used in making of woolen fibers who are elbowian. Once again, polyacrylonitrile can be abbreviated by PAN. Monomers or micromolecules of PAN is acrylonitrile, and these acrylonitrile, when undergoes repeated chemical combination in presence of acetyl or benzoyl peroxide, it gives rise to polyacrylonitrile polymer, right? And the characteristic property of this PAN is it cannot be attacked by fungi, it cannot be attacked by insects. Therefore, this PAN can be used as a substitute of woolen materials or wool. Therefore, it is used in making a rayon. This is similar to that of wool. So that's about chemistry of polyacrylonitrile. That's about the first topic, that is some important addition polymers. Second topic, today's second topic is some important condensation polymers. As you know, condensation polymerization means besides the main product, that is polymer, there must be a small molecule, HCl, H2O, NH3, etc. And for this, we took already an example, that is Decron or Terylene. Now directly we will move to the important condensation polymers. In this we have two important condensation polymers. They are, number one, polyamides. Children, remember, amide functional group is NH C double bond O. This is amide functional group. Amine functional group is NH2. This is amine and this is amide functional group. So whichever polymer we are going to get as an example in polyamides should have this functional group. That's what you need to remember. And best example for polyamides is nylon. This is the best example. And these nylons are of two types. First type is nylon 6-6. Put comma between 6 and 6, otherwise it becomes 66. Right? In previous class, first taught what do these 6 and 6 in nylon 6-6 indicate. Now let us see how is it formal formation, its property and then use. Remember, this is polyamide polymer, so it should have CO NH group in it. The monomers involved in this are hexamethylene diamine. This is hexamethylene diamine. This should be n number of times, this micromolecule. Next monomer is CH2 four times COOH. It is nothing but adipic acid. Adipic acid. When these two monomers undergo polymerization, what changes are going to take place? Let us see. From first monomer, n number of hydrogen atoms are removed on either sides. From second monomer, n number of OH groups are removed in this way. So it gives rise to simple molecule, that is water. And the main product is, after removal of these hydrogen and OH groups from these two monomers, what we are going to get, if we club that, we will get the polymer. And that polymer is like this. And this is nothing but nylon 6,6. Right. So you have to practice these structures. Otherwise, you cannot draw the correct structure of nylon 6,6. Okay. That's about preparation. Next, properties. As far as properties are concerned, these nylon 6,6 polymers, they can also be taken as example for fibers. Right. So these have thread-like structures in them and they cannot be attacked by the microorganisms. Therefore, they are used in making of nylon sheets. That is first use. Number two, they are used in making of bristles of toothbrushes and those brushes which are used to clean the clothes. That's about uses of nylon 6,6. Next, second type of polymer, let us see, that is nylon 6. This is second type of polyamide polymer. Right. And monomer of this polymer, let us see. CH2, see how I am going, how I am showing the methylene groups. So in that way you need to show in the structure. Always bond should be towards carbon and nitrogen. This is the monomer of nylon 6 and it is called caprolactam. This should be n number of times. So when this undergoes polymerization, it gives rise to nylon 6. Here, bond is cleaved. The bond lying between carbon and nitrogen. As a result, we will get polymer in this way. This is nothing but nylon 6. This 6 indicates presence of 6 carbon atoms. Here, 5 carbon atoms. And here 1, and to that 6 carbon atoms. Now let us see its use, where it is used. Generally the vehicle's tubes, example cycle tube, when it is inflated, the pressure exerted by that cycle tube should be tolerated by the tire, cycle tire. So that cycle tire is reinforced or it is made more strong or strengthened with the help of cords, C-O-R-D-S. So if you damage or if you cut the cycle tire or any vehicle tire, you can see the cords, very thick threads. They cannot be broken easily, cannot be broken easily. So tension strength is very high. Those cords are made up of nylon 6. That's about preparation and uses. So properties, tension strength is very high. That's why nylon 6 is used in making of cords of the tires. That's about nylon 6. So polyamides over. Now let us see the polyester or polyester. That is second type of condensation polymer. that is polyester, is also called polyester. Best example for this is dacron. Polyester means ester linkages should be there in n number of times in that polymer. That is why it is said to be polyester. Monomers of this polyester are, let us see, ethylene glycol, one monomer. And second monomer is terephthalic acid. That's all. And when these undergo polymerization in presence of suitable catalyst at suitable temperature and pressure, from each monomer, hydrogen atoms and OH groups are removed in this way. So one product will be HNOH, means water molecules. N number of water molecules are removed. Now rest of the parts, if you join, like OCH2 double bond, this is dacron or terephthalene. So example for polyester is terephthalene. So monomers of terephthalene are ethylene glycol or ethane 1,2-diol, that is IUPACN, and then terephthalic acid. This is terephthalic acid. Its IUPAC name is benzene 1,4-dicarboxylic acid. That is IUPAC name. Right. Now let us see which is acetate, because in ester we should have ester functional group, that is COO. This is functional group of ester. This is there n times. That is why it is said to be polyester or polyester. Example, terephthalene or dacron. An important property of this terephthalene or dacron is this polythene gives non-wrinkle nature to the fibers. So whenever we go to shop to purchase cloth, we'll hold the cloth like this and we'll squeeze like this. When the cloth is squeezed like this, if it develops wrinkles or if it gets wrinkles, then that cloth will not be purchased. Some customers do not like that. So some customers want wrinkle-free clothes. So in order to make the cloth wrinkle-free, this terephthalene is blended in textile industries. As a result, the cloth so obtained will not get wrinkles. So it is used in making of wrinkle-free clothes. So that's about the chemistry of polyester. So chemistry of polyester includes its preparation, right? Its property and its use. This is preparation of terephthalene or dacron. Property is it gives wrinkle-free nature to the clothes when it is blended during textile industries. That is about chemistry of polyester. Dear children, you might have noted down the important points of today's topics. Right? Once again, you watch this video completely. Most probably today or tomorrow, the assignment pertaining to this will be uploaded in ERP, and attempt those questions and respond. Thank you, children.